Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to Someone of Scott's Selections here for Tuesday, August 24th. Before getting today's play of the day, quick recap of what happened yesterday. We had a nice winner with the Saints first half, -3 at -110 on DraftKings. Game went basically the exact way that I thought it was going to. I thought that Lawrence would struggle in the very tough environment of the Superdome. I thought Winston will look pretty sharp against this awful Jaguar secondary, which he did. New Orleans ended up coasting to a first half lead, and I said I didn't want the full game as the play of the day because C.J. Beathard scared me, and then Beathard had the ridiculous fourth quarter, which led to the backdoor cover. So pretty much went the way I thought it would, and the Saints ended up cruising to a nice first half winner. So we'll look for another winner here on Tuesday. So we're going to be transitioning over to baseball once again. It's going to be in a matchup between the Washington Nationals and the Miami Marlins, taking place at around 7:10 p.m. Eastern time. And for the play of the day, we like the Nationals team total over 4.5 runs at +110 on BetMGM. Time recording of 1:38 a.m. Eastern time. Coverings why I like the over in the spot for the Nationals. First of all, Washington, despite some lackluster results, has been really hitting the ball well lately. The Nationals have scored at least 5 runs in 4 of their last 6 games. And Miami's throwing in a starting pitcher once again that we have faded for the last couple of starts, and it has been quite profitable. It's Jesus Luzardo. Now, Luzardo, of course, was acquired in the Starling Marte trade, and since coming over to Miami, he has been absolutely terrible. He's made 4 starts with the Marlins. In those 4 starts, 17 and two-thirds innings pitched, 9.6 ADRA. He's also made 3 starts at Marlins Park, 13 innings pitched, 8.31 ERA. He's simply not good, and I think that the Nationals should end up performing well against him. What might surprise you about Washington is the fact that even though this team is ranking 17th in runs per game, which is slightly below average, the Nationals randomly have the highest OPS in the league against left-handed pitching. I'm sure a lot of you didn't know that. I wasn't aware of it before I started doing research on the game. But the Nationals have hit lefties extremely well all season long, and I think that'll translate well against this lefty that's been really underwhelming for the entire season, especially over the last month. Plus, if you want to talk about what the Nationals have done recently against Miami, this team has fared well offensively. The Nationals have scored at least 5 runs in 3 of the last 4 meetings. But at the end of the day, I know we faded Luzardo in his last start against Atlanta. We had the same exact play, team total over 4.5 for Atlanta, and I believe they scored 4 runs in the 4th inning against them. Luzardo only went 3 innings because he couldn't get an out in the 4th, and the Braves ended up scoring double digits. I think you'll probably see the Nationals get to at least 6 here. Luzardo might be able to develop into being a competent starting pitcher in a couple of years, but right now he is pure fade material. And Washington's been hitting the ball well lately. They've hit lefties well all year long. I think Luzardo should struggle, probably give up 3 to 4 runs, probably in about 4 innings of work. And Miami's bullpen is, I'd say, average at best, but on the average day, below average. I think Washington, with 9 guaranteed at-bats on the road, should get to at least 5, and especially at plus money. I got to give this out because I think there's a lot of value on it. It's a play that I, once again, here for Tuesday, August 24th, is going to be on the Nationals team total over 4.5 runs at +110 on BetMGM. Bye, everyone.